cruelty couldn't swallow. Fill my empty space. Be my one and only. My innocence betrays.
Ich habe die Tür gesagt. Ja, ich habe das dann jetzt auch. Ja, ist der noch geil? Okay. Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you to the Orlando Pirates Football Club Choir for the musical item. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. By way of introduction, my name is Victor Ramathesele, and I have the singular honor and privilege to having been assigned by the Tshabalala family to run the proceedings as we bid our final farewell to our departed brother, Tokolo Makesh Tshabalala. Without much ado, we are going to start with the proceedings, and I'm going to ask each and every one of us to rise as we usher the family into the auditorium and the body of the departed, Tokolo Tshabalala. Thank you.
Peace.
Bafana, Sesgenile enkonzweni mshengu shabalala donga lika mavuso stoba snotuli osingaba ngoba sesa nomlandakazi okwathi umhlangavulu dilikile kanti umhlangavulu samile okwamahlokoto kwahlokota timbile emgezeni taphuma busabalala wena wakwawawawa mfana kabrasten mshengu shabalala phezu kwendaba phethi kumkashi galo uye lona utukulo makesh sesifikile mshengu donga lika mavuso stoba snotuli wena wakwawawawa wena owathenga isithole esimhlophe uthi kungcono uqamba amanga kunekuthakatha njengishabalala phezu kwendaba donga likamavuso gijimani niyotshela ubaba umntwana ugangile kuthiwa wenze njani kunyathela ubulongo embikayise silapha mshengu njengishabalala donga lamavuso sidoba sinothuli singabangcoba seza nomlandakazi wathi umhlangavulu udile kanti umhlangavulu samile wabhodle ebandla kwazwakala ebandla emadodeni mshengu mshengu Mjengu siyabonga dokotela
siyabonga donga lamavuso sidaba selithule ladies and gentlemen you may be seated in the presence of the lord one more time on behalf of the Shabalala family and I welcome you to this august event as we are bidding farewell to Tokolo Shabalala A funeral service is twofold. It is a memorial service wherein we reflect and we celebrate the life of the departed. And on the other hand, it is a graduation ceremony. Graduation from life on earth to eternal life in heaven with our Lord and Savior. Having said that, I'm now going to call upon Bishop Steve Morewa to come and open the proceedings in prayer. Over to you, Bishop.
Let us pray. Modimo tletseng tswaro, modimo wa bo raitsho le bo maitsho. We want to give you thanks for this opportunity to meet in your name and in the presence of one another. We want to bless and thank you that we can come together. Re tlo go lebogela so bolela ngenxa yempilo ka tokollo. Lord, lead us in this service. May it be a service of celebration as we say farewell to our brother, our cousin, our child, Tokolo, and our colleague. And be with us as we share moments that we had with him here on earth. Thank you that you are waiting to receive him in the everlasting arms of your son, Jesus the Christ. And to you be all glory and honor now and forever. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, I take this opportunity to acknowledge in our presence this morning the acting member of Executive Council for Sports, Arts and Culture in the Gauteng Provincial Government, who is also the chairperson of the African National Congress in the Gauteng Province, Mr. Panyaza Lesufi. I also take this opportunity to acknowledge in our midst this morning Chairperson of Orlando Pirates Football Club, Dr. Evan Khoza. Similarly, I acknowledge chairperson of Kaiser Chiefs, Mr. Kaiser Mtaung, or Dr. Kaiser Mtaung to be exact. And I thank you for having made the time to join the Tshabalala family and the Lockheed family this morning in our final send-off of our beloved brother, Dr. Lomagesh Tshabalala. Magesh was known in the musical sphere, and of course, his son of the legendary Stanley Skrima Tshabalala, who's known in the football circles. But he made a name for himself in his own accord and has left a mark, and an indelible mark at that, through the music that he's created and the creativity that he was endowed with. He worked for the longest time with our first speaker of the day, who's going to send a tribute to him. And ladies and gentlemen, allow me to welcome to the podium Pastor Kabelo Mabalane to come and say a few words and send a tribute to his friend, colleague, and brother indeed, Mr. Mabalane.
Thank you, Doc. Good morning. All protocol observed. In the past week, I've just been reflecting, and time is a fascinating concept. I've been thinking about time. You know, you can leave 5 minutes late and miss an accident. You can arrive 1 hour late for a function and just be in time for when they dish up the food. 3 weeks ago, we were performing in Mpumalanga, and if my maths serves me correctly, Tukulo only had 504 hours left on this earth, and I didn't know it. It made me also reflect and go back to the beginning of the 5 minutes before I met him. I can't remember exactly where I was 5 minutes before I met him, but I can tell you that the time that I did meet him, my life was never ever the same. I wailed like a little child this week in my wife's arms. It actually dawned on me, and I said to her, "Sweetheart, I'm sitting in front of you today because I met this man." My life was impacted, the direction of my life changed, and it was never ever to be the same again after I met Tukulo. Music was always the common denominator in our lives. We would fight, we would be the best of friends, but it was music. It was always music that connected us. Before TKZ, before Mashamplani, there was Two Slice. Two Slice was born in 1993. Two Slice only had one hit that no one ever heard of. I don't even remember the name of the song. We recorded one song, and I remember, Mama, I don't know if you remember, Ma, you gave us 250 rand for studio time to go record in Joburg. And we recorded one song. The content of that song was all about the girls that we were in love with at the time. That's the only thing that song was about. And we had dreams, we had big dreams. And I remember we bunked school, and Tebogo Mokobo, who sits here somewhere, was our manager for maybe 5 minutes, who was also at the same school as us. And we bunked school, and we left. We went to EMI in City Deep. We left St. Stithians here in Randburg, Rapalama Teksi, and we went all the way to EMI because we really believed we had a song that was going to change the world. But suffice to say, EMI heard it, and they weren't impressed. This past week has made me also reflect on a place that we spent a lot of time together, and it was at the back of the house, of Tukulo's house in Fourways. And we'd always go to the back of the house. We would wait for Tukulo's dad to leave, because he would leave first, and then his mom would leave, and then we'd go to the back of the house to resume our extracurricular activities. We were not reading, I can guarantee you that. We were not studying. If you saw a newspaper, it was used for a completely different... it had a completely different role, if you saw a newspaper. But as funny as that may be, that back of the house was where it all started. That back of the house was when we started to believe. That back of the house, oftentimes, Zwai would find us at the back of the house. And we'd be all three there, resuming our extracurricular activities. The back of the house taught me so much, because that's where we spoke, that's where we dreamt, that's where what became of our lives first existed in our hearts. It happened in the back of the house. And I go back to this moment every single time when I dream, when I face a challenge, when I step out into unknown territories, I go back to that moment where we had nothing, but all we had was the confession of our mouths and what we believed in our heart. Because I really believe that everything starts in our hearts. And what we eventually became, what we eventually saw in our lives, started in our hearts. Tukulo, what a privilege it has been, and it still is, to have been a passenger in a car that you drove, to be a catalyst that changed the world. There's a lyric in one song that I wrote. It goes, Uthulithilis wangfaki plug, umakesh wangbonisa ukuthi itsotsi njani mayine krag. And it's so true, because it's Makesh that taught me to believe. Makesh taught me to believe in myself. Makesh saw in me what I didn't see in me for the longest time. He saw it from day one. He taught me how to be brave. He taught me how to be fearless. I'd like to take this moment to honor Mr. and Mrs. Shabalala. I'd like to thank you. I forced myself to be one of your children. You had four children. I was your fifth child. You clothed me. You fed me. You supported me. I'm the man that I am today because of you. We were sitting yesterday with Tukulo's mom, and one of Tukulo's mother's friends says, "Hey, you know Banaba? Banaba baby ba motolets. Baby's my mom, my biological mom. Baby ba motolets." And it's true, because my mom would only deal with just me at one time. She had to deal with the both of us at the same time. So thank you so much, Mr. and Mrs. Shabalala. I honor you. I thank you for everything that you've done. I thank you for Tukulo and everything that you've done. In closing, our lives drifted apart in the past couple of years. Yes, we were performing together, which is, again, testament to the fact that music kept us together, traveling together around the world. And the topic of faith would come up. And it's well documented. As I was introduced, I'm a pastor. I've given my life over to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Something that I've never wanted to force my convictions on Tukulo. I rather chose the stance of Francis of Assisi. He said, "Preach the gospel, if necessary, use words." I tried to let my life speak volumes. And it just blessed my heart that, Doc, am I okay for time? Okay, because I thought you were walking up to me now. It blessed my heart. Well, let me start off by saying this. There was a time when somebody was telling me a story about how Tukulo went to a camp, and there was a man there who shared the gospel, who shared the love of Christ, and Tukulo received Jesus Christ as his Lord and Savior. And I remember this week when I was praying and I was saying, God, is he with you? Please show me a sign that he's with you. The next morning I get an SMS from DDA. DDA sends me an SMS, says, I want to tell you that there was a time that Magesh, unprompted by anybody at a church service, walked up to the front and received Christ as his Lord and Savior. You know, the word of God says to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. I said to Tulitilis's mom this morning that heaven, there's a big fat party happening in heaven right now. Ki Tulitilis, ki Mandoza, ki Makesh. Diawa strong. It's happening. It's happening. It really blesses my heart that Tukulo got to experience the love of Christ. And I want to encourage every single one of you this morning and tell you that God loves you as you are. There's nothing you can do to make God love you more or less. No one is getting 10 out of 10. You will never get 10 out of 10. Don't fix yourself. Don't try to fix yourself and then get God. Get God and he will fix you. Magesh, we changed the world. We toured the world. We got arrested. We fought. We cried. We drove over 200 plus kilometers an hour on the highway. We won big and we lost big. We've lived 5 lifetimes in 30 years that I've known you. What a ride it's been. Rest in peace, my nigga. See you when I get there. Thank you.
Bapedi bare amabotse ga fetolwe. Stosa stolekwa. Thank you very much to Pastor Kambelo Mabalane for that moving tribute and eulogy to your departed friend. I had to give you extra minutes for you to say a few words, particularly quoting from the scriptures, because it's no coincidence that Kambelo becomes the first speaker among many others who are going to pay tributes to Tukulo today. And it is no coincidence that he happens to be a pastor of the Word of God. And it is also no coincidence that this specific venue is where he worships. Having said that, TKZ was a trio of Tukulo, Kambelo, and Zwai. And it would be a great injustice if after Kambelo has spoken, we didn't have Zwai Bala to come and pay tribute also to his friend. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming on stage Mr. Zwai Bala, paying tribute to his departed friend, Tukulo Tshabalala.
I've lived a life that's full. I traveled each and every highway and more, much more than this. I did it my way. then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all, and I stood tall, and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, 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 not me, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got, if not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and all the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it
Give one more round of applause for Mr. Zwaibala, ladies and gentlemen. You can definitely tell the Drakken Boys Choir in that performance. Unbelievable. Dugulo must be rejoicing wherever he is, hearing that kind of melody. We have lined up a few friends who are going to be brief and to the point, I hope. I hope they don't give me the unenviable task of having to stand up and nudging them off the podium. Because I can imagine that they are all very emotional this morning as they bid their beloved friend goodbye. But we are going to afford them the opportunity nonetheless. Kicking off, ladies and gentlemen, allow me please and accompany me as I welcome to the stage Mr. Sibusiso Sontshangase, a friend of Kabelo's, also a colleague in the musical world, sometimes known as Sibu Maloya, who's going to pay a tribute to his friend. Over to you, Mr. Njangas.
Sambile sibonile zenzile, sibuzwile ubuhlungu kwaba mnandi sajabula, sakwatelana, saxabana. Kota njalo tukulu begazu tispusu so I love you. Ngela ukubingelela umndeni ntutuze umama Shabalala no babu Shabalala. Andilahlekelanga nonke nodwa actually. Silahlekelwe sonke. South Africa yonke, continent yonke with such a talented, beautiful soul, uMakesh. Ngizoba briefly uMakesh beka noti at the same time uMakesh was very loving. Bazongifakazela nabozwaye some of the things engizozisho. uMakesh I've known him 1995 through uMdu. Actually I was working with uMdu and unkosikazi kaMdu bekumngani ka sisika Tukulo uDineo. So uDineo apparently utshele uMdu ukuthi hey kunentwana yasedladleni etalented ngicela ukuthi nimduze. Nangempela uMdu angitshele because uMdu that time bengekho i-decision or approval azoyenza without consulting me. Yimbe ngi-approve izinto mengithi uMdu no yabo. So uMdu athi eh yazi emfana ibraka Sara ithi kunentwana yakho beculayo mfana uthini sibusiso ngithi hayi ithizwakale sizwe. Nangempela afika uTukulo se CSR Studios la eBryanston. That time is prepare ama instrumental uMdu prepare ama instrumental weMashamblane. Besibiz ngeyikopi siqeda ukwenza i-focal next day, the previous day. Mekafika uTukulo angene. Asifika sibingelele ibhumba nje ngene ibhumba nje meyingena le bhumba. Fike sibingelele all ama chants in grand buffet sharp sharp by moja. Sithi avele ungene kubhuti. Abaziyo ke ibhuti ukuthi abazistu itudo leza kudala ngikhuluma ngama Backroom Studios. Bekunebhuti bungena ngale muva ofika ucule. So mongale angeke usizwe mesikhuluma sesiyamhleba ke uTukulo sekangenile ngale. Sithi hey u fridge lo. So abo fridge ebesiba interpreter as ama model siyekazi. Yilaba bami babuye esikoleni balahlela incwadi phezulu kwesofa avula ifridge what's in the fridge mom. So abo Tukulo uzo uMdu came up with that name ukuthi abo fridge. So angene ke ufridge ngale meka ngene ufridge amamela I was surprised ayazo walahlela ibeat seyikhona ichorus phansi ngeyithuba bakufuneka afake iverse awangena uTukulo washaya line yakhe cam kuthi sibheki kamukuthi uyasifrustan sabhekana noMdu one take kaphuma uTukulo mekaphuma show my chance and grand sithi izolo fridge lo. So me and Mdu that time were very close besamangani si tight kanje bengekho hence ngishilo ukuthi bengekho uMdu into angayenza without mina. So uTukulo when he came I'm fana wayetshontsha relationship he stole my heart mina noTukulo sigcine sesijikela uMdu. Because even the time mina noMdu singasaboni ngasolinye mengitshela uTukulo ukuthi ayifana mina ngathi ngizoyiyeka le group ngiyoqala isolo yabo ngiyophanduka uzigayela isolo lathi uTukulo ayifana mophuma nami ngiphuma nawe. So after that mina ngihambe ngiyedeba ngenza idemo came back mengibuya ngihlangana noGoofy bang iPolygram actually ngitholele istudio ngihlangana noGoofy Goofy the first song that we did noGoofy sayenza imaloya bese senza imaloya. Besifakela uMdu amaloya actually that was the Neo actually uthe ngoba uMdu unrobile ethi sihambe simbize la maloya. So when I did that song amaloya actually there was a song that was dedicated to uMdu. So, so we did that song acabanga ukuthi hey amaloya loya mara this song bese ithumo sibiza amaloya ngabiza uTukulo wangena wathi abantu bomthetho man phazama wena sokufakela bona. But in short uTukulo was very jolly a very loving person. Bekanda bangana abaningi uTukulo he had a lot of fans most of them bakhona la they became friends because of Tukulo's heart. uTukulo bekamukela abantu. I remember the other time this is my son uSihle. uSihle was loving uTukulo so much bebathandana. Umntana mukhulile today is because of uTukulo. Ifamily yami mina remember that time yimi bese nginabantwana bangabantwana bona and all the time uTukulo will make sure ukuthi noma iTK izibhukiwa ngingabhukhwanga mina bekenza sure ukuthi usowa kasali samba naye athi wena sibusune abantwana and bekangichaza ke mengabe siyahamba sigigini uthole ukuthi ngiyadelaya ngiyasageza ngisazilungisa because ngithanda ukuziphoshonga athi wena sibusise wena wena sibusise ucabanga ukuthi uclean mara yazi uyamazi ubaba wami ukuthi uklini kanjani. Uyamazi uStanley Shabalala ukuthi uklini kanjani. Emotweni yakhe akunamamat, ngithi wayenganamat. Athi ngihamba ngiyi-1, why should ngihambe nabantu? Kuzoncilisa abantu emotweni. So I remember the last surprise uTukulo sisi ngibuye uyolanda uSihle esikolweni. We're busy with album ethi KZFA because uTukulo was spot on. Yonke into ayenzayo, uma sikenzi bekuzo record ingoma, uTukulo bese kanama lyrics before. Sina sase busy nama ballpen, sacabanga ukuthi soyenzana iconcept yengoma, uyangena ulahlela ichorus, ulahlela iverse. Already sika senzela ispanza ba is, ngena silahlela ama verse wethu, lahlela ama verse wethu. The other time I was fetching uSihle esikolweni asasemncane, wayena 6 years, he's 29 years now. When I fetch him esikolweni, uTukulo angena athi Sihle ozala amfake ngale kubhuthi simangele sonke ukuthi kwenzakalani senze izinja zami bekangena naye kubhuthi khuphula imaki ambeka esitulweni esiphezulu afika amhlebele hayi aphuma abuya athi boy dlala ibeat adlala ibeat uzwayo mekadlala ibeat iqale izinja zami meqala izinja zami sizwe ngomuntu athi ngeke nize nilunge. So that was my cash. Ngizothi ngizomkhumbula umngane wami, ngizomkhumbula umfowethu. Hayi mina ngedwa, sonke. Njengoba ngishilo ukuthi eSouth Africa continent silahlekelwe. Ngizohlala ngimthanda njalo, ngiyathemba ukuthi la khona umphefumulo wakhe uphumule ngoxolo, and ngithemba ukuthi la khona uzoba idlozi elihle to us kwi-industry, abangani bakhe, abafowethu nakwifamily yakhe. Ngiyabonga.
Siyabonga baba uNjangas. Sibuma loya. Immediately after him, we are now going to get a tribute from Mr. Linda Mqina. Linda, are you here?
Good morning, everybody. Sanbonane. To the Tshabalala family, we send our condolences. I hope you feel surrounded by lots of love. This is a profound, sad one, though even in this time of grief, I cannot help but reflect on the many wonderful experiences that I've had with you, with my friend Tukulo. In navigating this loss, it's important for me to remember how much richer my life has been as a result of my friendship with Tukulo. Tukulo, you were selfless, you were generous, you were charismatic, you were charming. You were encouraging, you were talented, you were creative, inspirational, full of fun, loved to smile, and we always had lots to laugh about. I am convinced that is why we enjoyed each other's company. I will forever be grateful to you for allowing me to express myself, to design and direct all your body of work, from CD sleeves to marketing campaigns for all your great music. This was a great feat for me. This will forever remain in my memory for the longest time. We really created some good work, and I know that one day it will keep your memory alive, and I will cherish this forever. Your gratitude showed up timelessly throughout the years in how much you valued what we did. I know that one day we will meet again and continue where we left off. You are gone. You are gone from our sight, but never from our hearts. May her soul rest in peace.
so in and
siyabonga baba umgcini. We can understand your pain and the loss of your good friend. It is a pain that is shared by you and many of his other friends and colleagues. It is a pain that is shared by his mom and by his dad. But we all believe in the warm embrace of our Lord Jesus Christ for our healing. The Bible tells us that Job had lost everything. Job had lost his riches, his animals, his fields, his children, his wife, and his health. But he still had the temerity to stand up and say, I know that my Redeemer liveth. Ke a tseba go ba molopoli wa ka o te. Ke a itse gore morekolodi wa ka wa tshela. Ndiyazi ukuba umkhululi wami uhlile. Nokuba wosuka ekupheleni emiphezo komhlaba. Naxeshikwe nemva kwentlonzo yam sekubhujiswe umzimba lo. Ndothi noko enyameni yam ndimbone uThixo. Endangumbona ngokwam namehlo wam aya ngumkhangela engenguye umbi. We know that our Redeemer liveth. Sithi dudu abakwashabalala. Anilahlekelanga nodwa, silahlekelwe sonke ukuhamba kwalo mfana uTukulu. I'm now going to call upon Mr. Lucky Ramapepe, who's going to make a tribute as a friend to the late Tokolo, who will be closely followed by a speech by a family, neighbor, and business partner, Mr. Donovan Robinson. Can I get both of them to ascend the podium so that they can speak immediately one after the other in the interest of time?
Good morning, everyone. Please, if you can bear with us, it's been a hectic week. We haven't been sleeping since we had the news of our friend here. So I'm gonna try to be fast and make it short as per the request. But firstly, I would love to send my deepest sympathy to the family of Shabalala, and also pay homage to the very same family, and to the church, to all the pastors that are here, including Pastor Mavalani. I want to pay homage as well to the siblings of Tukulo, the legendary TKZ band, the TKZ family, and the entire management behind it, distinguished guests that I've noticed during the week. I know we've got leaders that are here in government, distinguished guest in entertainment, celebrities, in the world of soccer as well, the world of politics, and to all South Africans and all our people in the neighboring countries and everybody in the world who's streaming this on social medias and all. So I've known Tukulo for quite some time now. I think it's more than 10 years now. And to be honest with you, I was a fan of Tukulo. I'm one of those that were a fan of Tukulo. But we became friends, and from friendship, we moved to, I think now we had reached a brotherhood relationship, because Tukulo was all the time at my house. You know, we did things that really, I think, just friends wouldn't do. That was my friendship with Tukulo. I can tell you a lot of stories about him, but for the sake of time, I think there are a few things that I can boldly associate Tukulo with. His humility, ladies and gentlemen, was out of this world. He had a big heart. He believed that things, you know, should be given out. He was giving. He had unconditional love. You know, Tukulo was one of those guys who would just love you for, you know, you would ask yourself that, why is this guy with me? You know, he was not associated with things or fame, or that was Tukulo, as Bu has alluded earlier on. The wisdom, but I think I later find out that he got his wisdom from Dati Shabalala. You know, because Tukulo had a lot of wisdom that I think most of us was not even aware of. The sense of humor as well, ladies and gentlemen, it was out of this world. And talking about the sense of humor, you know, now that we are back in church again, I remember we were once invited to one of the big churches in town with Tukulo. And shout out to Sandy. Sandy invited us to one of the churches in town, and we actually went to church for the very first time after a very long time with Tukulo. We didn't even know what to wear, but we accepted the invite, and we became part of the congregation. So as we were sitting in church, and the pastor requested everyone to stand up and to start praying in tongues. And you know, everybody stood up, and then they were up, moving up and down, praying in tongues. And Tukulo looked at me and said, "Rama Pepe, Rama Pepe." And then I replied to him and said, "Chavalala, chavalala." And then we both stood up, and then it was like, "Rama Pepe Chavalala, Rama Pepe Chavalala." Yeah, I'm gonna miss that character, ladies and gentlemen. That was Tukulo. But there's a lot that we did together, ladies and gentlemen. And then coming to his wisdom, you know, Tukulo, I remember he once, we used to talk about a whole lot of things, ladies and gentlemen, like from science to politics to, you know, spirituality. And I remember we used to talk about death a lot. And one of the things that I remember about him say, you know, talking about death, he said to me, "Uyazingfana Luciano, umuntu akafi. Luciano, your spirit will never die." He said, "How do you know this?" And then he says to me, "No, man, you remember I was once in a coma and I was not perturbed." You know, that's the term that he used to. I was not even perturbed, because, Mina, I was somewhere else and I saw things there. You know, I'm even looking for a painter who can even paint all these things that I saw during that time when I was in a coma. So he had a strong belief that umuntu agafe, and I still believe that Tukulo is not dead. He's amongst us, because he strongly believed in that. And the other wisdom that he had was that he believed that the spirit of, you know, the spirit of ownership, owning things, it's not helping. Like, you know, as people, we believe that this is your house, this is your car, this is your kids. You know, you always think these things are yours. They are not yours. You must let things go. You are given things just for you to manage and help or assist other people. You know, that's how that was his belief in terms of the spirit of ownership. And I remember he even said to me, "You see, Luciano, I don't even own my music. You know, my music has been owned by the people across the world." So he was very wise to call, and he would always tell me about his name that, "You know, Luciano, my name is Tukulo Hofelamo, and some people don't even know what it means. You know, it means freedom, Luciano. When you are with me, be free. Say anything that you want to say to me and ask anything that you want to ask." You know, he strongly believed in his name as well. And, you know, I've been thinking for the past days, if Tukulo was still around, what is it that he could have said? And I think I know that he was gonna let us know that we must actually let him free, because his name is Tukulo after all. I'm gonna miss him. And to my friend Tukulo, thank you for being in my life. Like other speakers have said, Otukulo will actually put confidence in you. When I'm Kenya Black, and there are certain things that I've done in my life, good things, because of him, showing me that I need to have courage, I need to stand up for myself. So he became a brother to me. He would also talk about his other friends. Most of his friends, he would talk about Zwai, Kabelo, Atia, when I like young Rasela, Malay music, Nyana, why don't I fago Kabelo, Vanyas, Lentwana, Myangsha. You know, that was the love that he had for other friends of his. He would talk about Makasket, Yojira, you know, Terry Pinana, there's a lot, Chris, you know, Tukulo loved his people, loved his friends. And in closing, I would say, Zaza, I'm gonna miss you. And all the time, I know that you will be around, because you said, Asifi, you said you'll never die. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Donovan, and we have had the honor of being Tokolo's neighbor for the last several years. And he became known to us as Daneo's brother, because Daneo started visiting us first. And over lockdown, I think he moved back home or something, and Daneo said to us the one day, "I'm gonna bring him to come and meet you guys." And they arrived, and we immediately just clicked. And the generosity that we have had from the Chabalala family has been amazing. We live in a neighborhood where there is still see-through fences between us, and it's been quite open, and Tukulo always just had us smiling. He became quite fond of visiting us. And in 2015, we decided that we were going to develop our property as an urban retreat. And when he came along and he said to me, "But Zaza, what is an urban retreat?" And I said to him, you know, Tokolo, we're going to bring the mountain to you. You don't need to go to the mountain. And he liked that. And we kept on visiting, and he became more and more fond of the property and of visiting with us. And about on the third visit, I said to him, you know, Tokolo, I actually Googled you, and I didn't realize you were so famous. And he said, well, Zaza, keep it that way, because that's the way I like it. He says, I don't need to be famous here. I just need to be friends. And it was just incredible getting to know him on this level. And I think because of that, we got to know several parts of him. And sometimes he'd open up to me and come and chat to me about issues and problems. And we'd go out into the garden and have a walk. And he would always end up laughing. And we'd always end up making the world right. And I love that saying which said, we thought we were changing ourselves, but we were actually changing the universe. And Tokolo was just like that. And I noticed that he wasn't really working much when we met him. And so I kept on asking him, like, what new songs are you doing? What are you up to? Because I was really keen and interested. Coming from a creative field myself, I recognized that his creativity and my creativity were very much the same, even though we were applied for totally different arts. And he said, I'm not really writing right now. I'm not really doing much. And I said to him, you know what your problem is, Tokolo? You need to actually stop drinking so much. You need to get that creative mind of yours out, because you are going mad inside here, because there is too much creativity in there. You're driving yourself mad. And he just looked at me, and a week later, Danao came, and she said to us, Donovan, what did you say to Tokolo? So I said, I told her what I'd said to him, and she says, but oh, not even our mother speaks to him like that. But it seemed to have made an impact, because a couple of weeks ago, he actually came to us with a whole bunch of songs that he played for us, and he was so proud of it and so proud of his work. And it was incredible to have him with us on Friday night as well, because the previous Friday night, because it was full moon, and we have a wellness evening at full moon in order to promote wellness and getting out in the open and just enjoying the stars and the moon above you. And so we have a drumming circle there as well. So Tokolo popped around, and he was sitting whistling to the drumming and everything. And when the drummers took a break, he kind of said in a soft voice, you guys are good. You must maybe come jam with my band a bit. We want to make a DVD. And the drummer said to him, hey man, what, are you going to do a DVD with your phone or what? At that stage, I hadn't realized that they didn't know who he was, because he was sitting in the shadows. And so the one said to him, but how many members are in your band anyway? And he said, 3, but the guys didn't hear him. So they said, how many members are in your band? And so I said, don't you get TKZ? 1, 2, 3, they're 3 members. So he said, yeah, man, but what has TKZ got to do with it? So I said, this is the T from TKZ. And they practically went down on their hands and knees apologizing. And everybody at that event that night were absolutely amazed, because Tokolo just entertained them all quietly and with jokes and just in his own special way that we became so used to. The neighborhood is not going to be the same without him. But I know that he always said to me, Don, you have to keep on building your dream. And I believe in you. And I said to him, you know what? If you believe in me, I'll have the courage to do it. And he would always get so excited. And I'd show him our new ideas of what we're going to build next, like lighthouses for overnight rooms and all sorts of stuff. And he'd just say, Zaza, you bloody mad. But I love it. And eventually, we got used to him calling us my genticles. And then Zaza with that little wave of his. And we just all loved his visits. And he used to pop around often and sometimes stay a little bit too much. And we noticed that the first couple of visits were always chaperoned by Danao, because I think she was a little bit scared about what he might get up to. So we really, as a family, got to love him. And we are going to miss him, but we do know that he will always live on. And as we build on our dream further, I know that he's watching over us. And he once said to me, when we hit rock bottom after COVID lockdown, because our business suffered extremely badly, and without even saying a word, there was some money put in our account.
And when I thanked him for it afterwards, he said, Zaza, you don't talk about that. So I said, but why did you do it? Why did you give us the money? And he just said, because you're my neighbors. That's what neighbors do. And that really is what neighbors do. And that's what Tukolo really was to us. And we shall always miss him, but we are always grateful for the bit of time that we knew. And I'd like to give our sincere condolences to the family, as they know. And we would love to be there with you as you guys still come to grips with life without him. And then carrying on with all the other things that come to you. So thank you for listening. And to our best neighbor and friend, we will always miss you.
Mhlabile ho tla ba jwang ha ke siya go wena e bona Registration HB34JZ. Yes, JZ. GP. Posh. Please, your lights are on, and we are too decently dressed to give you a push when you leave for the summit. Similarly, Audi registration FK69FRGP. Please go and sort out your vehicles. Your lights are on. Bishop, the gospel according to John is different from the three other synoptic gospels. And it has the singular honor of the only other book in the Bible that starts by saying in the beginning. But it is famously known for the seven I ams that you find in that gospel. I am the light of the world. I am the door, I am the bread of life, I'm the good vine, I'm the good shepherd, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, and I'm the way, the resurrection. Ke nanne tsela le bophelo. Kapa ha iqetela re. Ke nna tsela le bophelo. Ho rialo Morena. Ya dumelang ho nna le ha shula o tla phela. Me ya phela nga dumela ho nna. A ke ka ishala ka ho sa fele. On that note, I'm now going to invite, on behalf of the family, to pay tribute to her departed brother, Madame Kutlwano Tshabalala. Over to you, my sister.
Oh, is this music for me? Okay. This whole week, standing here is a little surreal. And I still can't believe it, I still can't imagine. But true to form, till the very last, Tukula had a way of surprising you, so here we are. In the past week, I've been asked to describe who my brother was, what my favorite memory of him was, what kind of person he was, pick a couple of words to, you know, best suit him. But I had none, because how do you describe a man who was just out of this world, a full-on character, crazy, unpredictable? You can't describe Tukulo, you had to experience him. He was just an experience. But for this day, I guess, and speaking to my siblings and friends and going through the emotions, I've picked some three words. The first word is brother. Tukulo took his job as a brother very seriously. He loved everyone, he wanted everyone to feel love, and in our family, things like siblings, cousins, friends don't really apply, because my parents created an environment where you come home the first time, you're a guest. The second time, they will send you. So you are part of the family now. So being part of the family, being with you all the time was something that Tukulo always wanted to do. Speaking to my siblings as well in terms of what they felt and how they were going through, all of them had one thing in common. Tukulo was always there for them, no matter what situation, whatever the situation was, no matter how many times we fought, because he had a way of annoying you, but he'd be the first one to try and make up with you. And if you were going through something, Tukulo was there for you. If you needed to climb up a tree and shout, he would let you climb up a tree and shout, and he'd join you and tell you to go higher, you know? So he took his job as a brother very seriously. The second one is character, because he was just a character. Everything about him was just weird and exciting, but also comforting at the same time. You were always entertained by him, and even if you were going through a bad time, he had a way of pulling you out of that bad time and making you realize that you could get out of it. Even though he may have been going through something bad, but he'd just be like, nah, let's not be Mickey. We can get through this. For me, the last one is shield. Most of people who know me know that I'm not a talker. I don't like people much, but here I am. And he knew that about me. And he always wanted to protect me from people who expected more from me or to be more like the family members who are go-getters, also characters, but that wasn't me. And he was my shield from that, from our siblings and from the world. And as much as he was a public figure, he never let it affect me. So I was blissfully unaffected by all the publicity and all the hoo-ha that went around him. But when the rumor mills got too bad, he'd always send me a message and say, you know me, and I love you the most. And I'm the type of person, and so was he. We were brutally honest with each other all the time. But when we fought, we fought. When we loved, we loved. We spoke all night and shared true feelings with each other. When I was having a problem or I needed to do something and go speak to my dad, he'd give me some advice, you know, this is what you must do or whatever. And then, you know, you go to your dad with your problems and dad would be like, Yazine. Utukulo yena akangihluphi. Yes, uyaganga, maka akangihluphi njengani. Akangihluphi. And then I'd have to go back to him and be like, nah, dude, your strategy didn't work. But then in the background, I know he would go to him and my dad and just be like, nah, man, just help, it's okay. My mom and I are also very similar, so we also fight like cats and dogs. And when she doesn't agree with my idea of what life should be, it was Tukulo who would be like, "Mom, let her go. Let her do what she needs to do." Standing here in front of you knowing that my shield isn't going to be here, my own piece of armor, is daunting, but I know that he's always with me. And plus, if I did anything funny or start crying, he's in my head and telling me, "No, puppy, you can't cry. You look ugly when you cry." So I'm trying to maintain myself. I love you, we love you, and I miss you. Thanks.
That's Mom's favorite song, Tukulo, Mfana Kamshengo. A special dedication from Madam Popo Tshabalala, sending it to her departed son. Beautiful song, Mama Kamshengo. Thank you one more time. Ladies and gentlemen, in the interest of time, ndizawukhawulezisa ngoku, ndisengele emlonyeni, ndibethe ke nditshekwe umntu okhwele isithuthuthu. Ndiyenzela uba abaphathi bentlelo bangazi bade balwe nam. I'm now going to invite to the podium Football Administrative Manager of Orlando Pirates Football Club, Mr. Floyd Mbele, to come to the podium and read out for us and everybody who's watching this event a special tribute from Mr. Stanley and Mrs. Popo Tshabalala to their departed son. Mr. Mbele, over to you, sir.
Mr. Master of Ceremonies,
the bereaved family, all protocol observed. Tukulo's passing caused the family to pause and seek answers to many things that we do not seek answers for in our everyday life. Everything from the logistics of arranging a family to seeking answers from God about timing. Late at night, when everybody had left, the family reflected on the loss and on who Tukulo was to us. Kutlwano, the family's chief interrogator, armed with a pen and notepad, asked questions. What was your favorite memory? What was the best advice you gave? So the questions came. The reflections and reminiscing created moments of smiles, tears, and outright laughter. Thanks to Kutlwano, we had quiet reflections of our own. We've been asked many times, is Tukulo your favorite child? Did we see all along that he'd be a famous musician? How do we raise our talented child? How do we deal with the negativity that comes with fame? The people that ask these questions are of different ages. They asked, we presumed, because they were in search of a recipe, a set of ingredients and instructions to prepare what seemed like a dish, a known outcome, a special child. Married couples even asked, who played the good cop and who played the bad cop? I was even asked if I was the tiger mom. I had found out what a tiger mom was. My answers to the tiger mom question was simple. I had a husband, four children, two girls and two boys, and a job. I did not have the benefit of following any of them around. I did what needed to be done. All I asked was that they apply themselves fully to the best of the opportunities that they received. I remember Tukulo coming into the field when there was no player already for 5 years. He came in Dineo's pitch. Dineo was the happiest lady to have a younger brother. Tukulo was the man. After the two of them ruled the kingdom, for 7 years came through two other players, one after the other, only 1 year apart, Dumelo and Kutlwano. If you didn't know better, you'd think they were twins. They captured and captivated. The question, who is your favorite child, was best answered by Kutlwano, who besides being the last born, contends that they all got special care in the areas that they require care. Kutlwano quotes her father saying, Tukulo hantswenye nix, lantswenye Kutlwano. Not long thereafter, he will hear Tukulo being told the same. This time, Brasten would say, Kutlwano is the baby. Hantlupi, why hantswenye so mak Tukulo? She also quoted her mother saying to all four of them in response to COVID, come home, my children. If COVID kills you, let it find you at home. The word favorite is probably most appropriate when one considers that we wanted the best for all of them in different ways. We both agreed that their way was the key to their success, and this was underpinned by their education. I have to admit at not being open-minded about Tukulo as Tukulo's mother was. I was particularly pleased when Tukulo expressed his interest in being an engineer. He would have been a stable career, life, and I remember thinking this would have been appropriate for him. When engineering was replaced by marketing, I remember saying, I don't mind. All you need is a degree and a tertiary education. And before I knew it, he was asking me to listen to these songs and beats. All I could see was the struggle and the plight of the artists I knew. I was asking him to be kind to himself. He was not hearing any of that. Then came the tapes, the studio time, the request for money, and more money. In his defense, it was not money to spend on himself. It was the money to feed his passion. I credit and thank Mdu Maselel for helping me understand. Then after what seemed to me like a lifetime, it happened. He had cracked the puzzle. He looked like he would be able to support himself. He became completely independent. Then I had a different worry. Would he save and not lose all? One of Tukulo's weapons of life was his charm and humor. He would enter the house and ask his mom, "Are you happy to see me?" Then proceed to sing, "You better treat me right or you'll never see me." He was the only child that called his mother by her first name. Always in song and happiness. They shared cooking recipes and they made and tried sauces together. You left us beautiful memories. The conversations about you remind us how lucky and special as a family we are. You are going to make a beautiful angel. Pass our regards to Mastinan and the rest of the family up there till we meet again.
Hana Gwenin Dumella Kinegitlare how he live on about Tessile, Tolandi Roki, Lema Mele, Kalela Roka, Lisiaba Halem Rao, Ping Sibaka Ki Parfek, Roka Poho, Enzo, Manso Poho, Pazo, Enzo, Yamazwa, Orlando Po, Yawaloswa Gidigua, Ribana, Yawaloswa Kebana Bomakepula, Gabuakama Kepula, Gato Samasa by Tobalese, Kahopula Banna Bom Hosnia Bomute, Gabosofa Sonke, Barusiba and Abadisabayana Bomba Tani Bompo Sula Gabosojan, Kerpohoi, Kiriki, Trella, one is the Gitan Senior. Kipo enzo mahlabi ya o aloswa ke dikwa ka re jwa le ka itsho hore ke po ye na selemo sena e kwatile e thothetse fata ka makwatsi hlaba tseding molateng di hlaba mokubelaneng mo ntsha e faswang ba ntshopoho selemo sena e khalemeleng ya tswa po ye di hlaba lenyelengele di sia di robetse mo fela ngwane so ke re hela ntate khosa thewa tlo thoba batho matsalo se tshaba ke sena se emi se re he mabhakabhaka kwenze njani. I'm saying this because Tukulo's dad is known for his work in football. And we often talk about South Africa's achievements, the 1995 Rugby World Cup, the 1995 Orlando Pirates Champions League triumph, the 1996 Cup of Nations, and many other achievements. But very little is said about one of South Africa's greatest sporting achievements off the field of play. And that is the 2010 FIFA World Cup that this country hosted ever so admirably. And I had the singular honor and pleasure of serving under him as chairperson of the 2010 FIFA World Cup local organizing committee, Dr. Evan Khosa. And I have the pleasure of reading out his special eulogy for Tukulo Shabalala, dated the 19th of August, 2022. We begin our parenting journey when we are not fully formed ourselves. It is a job we do without a manual or formula. And the beauty of all is what we lack in skills and experience, we have in love and hope. Irrationality is on most occasions an unwelcome trait. Love and hope, however, derive their strength from the fact that they are irrational. We love besides and beyond the circumstances. We hope besides and beyond the hopelessness engulfing us. Dineo, Tokollo, Tumelo, and Kutlano are by every stretch of imagination privileged children. They went to the best schools and they grew up in a loving home, from Dube through to Douglasdale to Mnandi. They are city children through and through, yet their mother wanted them to grow up in a pure urban setting, reminiscent of everything rural, an environment soothing to soul. Tokollo grew up and lived true to his name, freedom, and that was his power. He thought, spoke, and acted with utmost freedom. He was uninhibited. He had a calling and a blessing. He activated our nation, continent, and the world. And he did all this when he was too young to understand or fully comprehend his impact and reach. He was a true godsend, born with and for a purpose. Godsends require nurturing. In fact, they are in most instances, they demand it. And it is for this reason that I'm focusing my tribute to Tokollo's parents, Brasten and Meherieta Popo Tshabalala. I today wish to thank them publicly for the sterling job that they did, raising a star that, although born of them, was born for the nation and the world. Brasten and Meherieta, I salute you for your selflessness, your disproportionate allocation of your scarce resources to give your children the highest education the country had to offer. Besides your circumstances, talks to a selflessness that is beyond rational. You never considered nor counted the cost. Yours was a labor of love. I thank you for me and the nation. God sends, especially creatives, suffer more than they enjoy their talent. Humanity does not imbibe the generosity of their talent. It goes on to put them on an inhumane pedestal, taking away their humanity at every turn. They are not allowed human failings and are afforded to everyone. They live under a microscope, seeking to find fault in their every move. God does provide, and it is not a coincidence, but an act of God, that he was born of a mother that professionally a nurse, a loving hand that would kiss all the bruising better, and a practical father that, although he wished he pursued a career in engineering, supported his choice for a public life, just like he pursued his love for football. I know there's a lingering question we all ask, why so soon? God has provided us with many talents, yet God kept one thing away from us. We never know the moment, nor the circumstances under which we will be called. It is outside both our knowledge and comprehension. And that is the reason it is appropriately called God's time. Robala ka khotso ya Modimo, my boy. You captivated the world with your talent. You left the Kasi to a private school. Together with your friends, you did not only return to the Kasi in your music, you elevated the Kasi to the world. Your music defined a generation, and set the world on fire. May your soul repose peacefully. There is no doubt the heavens will rejoice. Where you are, the music and Gassi never stops playing. I thank you, Dr. Evan Khoza. Singabawo sesifike kwangqengetshe rifihlile sesihlohlolong sadidaba esikhaleni sikaNtombela. Under normal circumstances, protocol would dictate that another political official will make the introduction, but I'm almost certain that given the circumstances, the next speaker will understand. As I call on stage the acting MEC or member of Executive Council for Sports, Arts and Culture in the Gauteng Provincial Government, who also happens to be the chairperson of the African National Congress in the Gauteng Province, Mr. Panyaza Lusufi, to come up and give a eulogy to Tokollo Shabalala. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Program Director, Doc. To the Shabalala family, mom and dad of Tokollo, representatives of the church, represented here by Bishops Steve Moreo, the chairperson of Orlando Pirates, Dr. Ivan Khoza, the chairperson of Kaizer Chiefs, Dr. Kaizer Mtau, Tokollo's friends, TKZ family, representatives of government that's here, representatives of business, and the entire entertainment industry, fellow Monos. We enter this place still in a state of denial that our beloved Tokollo, my guest Shabalala, is no more. We try hard to refuse to accept, But as we gather like this in this fashion, reality hits home. We join the multitudes of our people, an endless list of various formations and organizations, in extending our sincerest condolences to the Shabalala family and the entire entertainment industry, in particular his friends and the TKZ family. We never thought we'll meet like this to bid farewell to you, our Kwaito legend certified Tokolo. Ours was to marvel at your dedication and hard work. Ours was to appreciate your humility and commitment to your trade. Ours was to appreciate the role you played to make us forever entertained. To us, as the Gauteng provincial government, Makesh was a great artist that inspired so many young people. He was a lyrical beast, an ambassador of our province, our country, our continent. But above all that, he was super talented as a singer, as a writer, and as a dancer. As Martin Luther King correctly captured it, only in the darkness can you see stars. Tokolo was a star, a pioneer of note, a star of our making. As we note this sad chapter of his passing, we hope and believe the family will remain strong and be consoled. In my home language, Barepepi Bachabalala, like birds, when one is shot and starts limping, other birds will also start to limp so that the enemy doesn't know which bird is limping. Today, all of us here are limping. We are one. We are the Chabalalas. May I strengthen you as a family. May I strengthen you as friends of Tokolo. May I strengthen you as those that loved his music and loved whatever that he was doing, that what we see today is a difficult moment, not to the family alone, but to all of us. As the Bible says, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Let all of us release our beloved Tokolo. Let's release him. Your voice in the music will always make us happy, and that's the sign of life well lived. Vaya sharp, Makesh. Vaya sharp, our number one tsotsi. Till we meet again, Mpinchak, together forever. Robalaka Khotso.
Thank you, MEC, for a brief, short, and impactful message, giving credence to the English saying that brevity is a soul of wit. I have made it my task to investigate nicknames. And in the process, one of the things I discovered that when I was growing up, when you were a good footballer and your name was Andries, you'd be called Banyaza. And this happened because there was one Andries Six Mabone Maseko from Guatemala Springs who used to play for Moroka Swallows, and became Six Mabone, and later Six Banyaza, and later just became simply Banyaza. So after that, there was Andries Chicha Sundowns, who was also called Banyaza. And of course, the speaker who has just left the podium, Andries Banyaza Lesufi. But I'm disappointed that none of the speakers who came to the podium today explained the nickname Makesh. And I'm saying it is not too late. When we leave here, we'll be at the cemetery, and maybe we'll give them one more opportunity for somebody to just explain, just for closure, just to tell us exactly where this nickname Makesh came from. Ladies and gentlemen, as we move towards the close of today's proceedings, to allow abefundisi ukuthi bayenze umsebenzi wabo njengoba kudingekile ukuthi mesimkhapha umfowethu simkhaphe ngenkonzo nelizwi likaNkulunkulu, kubalulekile ukuthi senze kanjalo nala kwamshini kuzinto zenziwa ngalolo hlobo. Mina njengesithunywa sabo ke sizulu sithi isithunywa sinacala, mina ngenza lokho ke ngithunyiweyo namhlanje. Madodana, I've been asked and requested by the family to read out the obituary. Ngizocela nje ukuthi nihambe an appropriate song as I go through this obituary. Tokolo Magesh Tshabalala was born on the 14th of October, 1976, in Phefeni, to parents Stanley and Henrietta Popo Tshabalala. He did his grade R at Immaculata Primary School and moved to St. Stephen's College, which he spent much of his formative years and later matriculated at Four Ways High School. He furthered his tertiary education in marketing. He didn't spend too much time trying to be in the books because music was his passion and what inspired him. Musically, Tokolo was super confident, sharp, a potent composer, and a lyricist. His music was always multi-layered with catchy lyrics, rapping, street lingo, and jazzy vibes. Tokolo's music activity kicked off when he formed the group Two Slice with his childhood friend, Kabelo Mabalane. As a professional, he joined Mashamplani with Mdu Masilela and longtime friend Sbu Maloya. With hit singles such as Hey Komp and As Fogol as Nicks, the group was embedded as one of the pioneers of Kwaito with much success, although short-lived, as members went their different ways. This is when Tokolo reunited with his high school friends Kabelo Mabalane and Zwai Bala to form TKZ in 1996. It was between their release of Take It Easy and Palafala that Magesh went on to record his first solo album titled Kusheshe with producer friend Godfrey Pilani. TKZ family, which included Sbu Maloya, Dr. Macheu, Kagiso Diseko, also known as Khwaiza, and Loiso Mbala, was born out of these close-knit friendships. Tokolo's solo career and catalog was growing simultaneously, adding three more albums, Ndabezitha, Varheid Iskat, and Longest Time. He also established his own production company, The Heist, also known as He Is Tokolo, which he used as a foundation to help discover and develop more up-and-coming South African talent. Tokolo collaborated with many of the big names in entertainment, including Ntu Masilela, Arthur Mafokati, Oskido, Tebe, Chiskop, Trompies, Mandoza, Brothers of Peace, New School, Vibe Squad, Crucial Zone, Helela, Crowded Crew, Cream, Kulichana, and many other artists. Dokula with Kisezi. They featured on recordings with international heavyweights such as P. Diddy and Pitbull. Also sharing the stage with the likes of Boyz II Men. His talents took him across the African continent and saw him perform on some of the world's best stages. In addition to the multi-platinum recordings, Magesh's musical accolades include record-breaking South African musical awards in one evening with TKZ and a Lifetime Achievement Award, Summer Award for the hit single with the late Mandoza titled It's All Right. Dokolo was a gentle soul, a shining star, and a people's person. He was also affectionately known as Supernova, Kush Kush, Gash, Heavyweight, Tiger, Susa All-Star, Number One Zuzi, Babeko, Guns, Izaza. He's survived by his parents, siblings, nephews, and nieces. Lala ngokuthula. Sohlala sikuthanda njalo. Shabalala. Mshingo. Dongala mavuso. Sidoba siluthulo. Wawawa. Rest in eternal peace. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the family, I wish to extend their gratitude for all the outpouring of messages, heartfelt sympathies and condolences that you have sent to them since the time the passing of Dokolo Shabalala was known to all of us. The family thanks the extended Shabalala family, as well as the Lokhi family. The family wishes to thank Dr. Evan Khoza, chairperson of Orlando Pirates, Dr. Kaiser Mtaung, chairperson of Kaiser Chiefs, the Premier Soccer League, all friends and participants from the music industry, all friends of the family from the football industry and fraternity, and all friends from the entertainment fraternity in general. The family also wishes to thank the National Minister of Sports, Arts and Culture, Honorable Nathi Mthethwa, the MEC or Member of Executive Council, Honorable Panyaza Lesufi, MEC or Member of Executive Council of Sports, Arts and Culture in the Gauteng Department, Gauteng Government, Honorable Mbali Hlophe, and all members of the Gauteng Provincial Government. The family further thanks the Executive Mayor of Johannesburg, Honorable Councillor Mpho Phalatsi and the City of Johannesburg in general, as well as the Secretary General of the Gauteng Provincial African National Congress, Mr. Thembi Nkosi Ngcisa. Further, the family would feel that it had not done a complete job if they didn't continue to thank Mr. Floyd Mbele, Football and Administrative Manager of Orlando Pirates, Mr. Tato Matuka, Mr. Lotlhogonolo Brandt. The family also wishes to thank Kupani Funerals for the job well done you know, all the funeral arrangements and the execution thereof, Rhema Bible Church for providing the venue and many other forms of support to the family, as well as Bishop Steve Morewa, and many other people that we will continue to mention that we may not have mentioned, but who have played a very integral and important part in ensuring that the family can share the burden of the grief that has engulfed them. Siyabonga, Realebuwa. I'm now going to call upon Bishop Steve Morewa to come and conduct the final service. And I also want to say to Tukolo, as the bishop ascends the stage, on behalf of your parents, siblings, family, friends, and all those whose lives were touched by yours, we shed our tears for the pain of parting with you. But we take comfort in the fact that you are now in a better place. We will miss your beautiful company, your warm sense of humor, and your enduring smile. You have left a musical legacy that we challenge your colleagues to keep alive in your memory. Having had you in our lives has been nothing but a blessing, and we thank God for it. Go well, Mfanagit. In you, heaven has gained an angel, and the world is the poorer for it. You have not died, for you'll continue to live in our hearts. Hamba kahle, mshingo, shabalala, dongala ngamafuso, sithoba siluthule, till we meet again. Over to you, Bishop.
Wa wandi tata la, wa wandi bekale, uche suno bubele, wandi tata la, wandi tata la, wa wandi bekale. Jesu no bubele, Jesu no bubele dami, u Jesu no bubele, Jesu no bubele dami, u Jesu no bubele, ewa, wa di tata la na wa. Wa wandi tata la wa wandi bekale noche sunobubele na.
Thank you very much. Let us pray. May I speak in the name of God who creates, Jesus who saves, and the Holy Spirit who guides us. Amen. Dr. Victor, thank you very much for leading us through the order of service and particularly the program part of it. You know, we as preachers, when somebody like you who has this special relationship with God and understand the scriptures, once you start quoting scripture, hey, maka stop others usatatin chumelo yam, you know. So by the time I preach, you have taken my points, but you did very well. Thank you very much for leading us. I really appreciate it. Ndade khoza ku hlompile hle ntate, Dr. Mutanku hlompile, MEC ku hlompile. Thank you very much. le batho ba modimo ka ofela ke a le hlompa ha mmoho le family ya Tshabalala. Last night I was having dinner with my grandkids, and then they asked me, "Hore, Baba, uya aphi ngomso?" And I said, "Tomorrow I'm going to a funeral." But yakabana, I said, "The guy by the name of Tokullo." But Tokullo, what does it mean? I said, "No, his name is Freedom." And I said, "He's an artist." But which group is it? I said, TKZ? And I said, what? Because they're 16 and 12. And I could see her, no, okay. They are still young. They don't know him. And then I said to them, Bantwana Bam, tomorrow night, I'll buy you pizza. And I'll come and tell you who this guy is. Because I wanted to know more about Tokullo, not the musician, not the artist, but I want to know, who are we talking about here? Now I don't know him. I just know Ntate Tshabalala. And Ritsane ko stadium, hare shebile Orlando Pirates. Ntate Khoza, last year I think you nearly got a summons from the lawyer saga. Hunter loser gago look at hey every game that we lose the blood pressure zarna di atlatloga, so to sue you for raising our blood pressure, so I know that Stanley gagolo ko stadium, I will always sit next to Omnyu Baba, so in the suit there, when these boys don't play well, I say to him, yes, because I can't do that as a bishop. And then now on Sunday, I'll go and pray for you, you know. But today, as I was sitting there, my brothers and sisters, as I was sitting there, I got a picture of who this guy was. And this is the picture I have. He was more than just an artist. He was fully human. I mean, for him, he must go to church and speak in tongues and say rapa rapa pepe pepe pepe, and you do the same and say chaba chaba whatever. He was fully human, and I wish I could have met him. I think he was a guy full of fun, and also I mean ebe ganga kodwa ingahluphi. I don't understand that. But also, he did not want to be famous, but he wanted to be friendly to all people. And also, sitting there as a Christian, I was saying, actually, you know, Dr. Vic, he displayed what I call the fruit of the Spirit. He was generous, he was full of love, he was selfless, he was full of gratitude, he was wise, he was friendly, he even spoke in tongues, as I said. He was inspirational, he was encouraging, he was spiritual, he was joyful, and also he was a fridge to make sure that Dijo are preserved, people's lives are preserved. So this is what I will share with my grandkids tonight. That for him, music, as Dr. Khoza said, was a calling. He was born for the nation. He lived a life with purpose. And he elevated ikasi to the world. And for this, we give glory and praise to God for the life of Tokullo. He truly lived a freed life. But then, how do we encourage one another in a day like this? Ke rata go leboga family ga Tshabalala for giving me this opportunity to come and share my thoughts and my meditation. To the extended family, we really appreciate this. To colleagues and to friends and everybody who's here, how do we help ourselves in times like this to deal with our loss and our pain? And thank you that I can do that. And the only thing I can do is to share from the word of God. Somebody who is a Muslim will share from Quran, and others will share from other sources in order to encourage themselves. I can only use this source that is called the Bible, which is a library of 66 books, which is God's story with God's people in God's time and in God's world. So I want to say to us, in this library, there are lots and lots of stories of how families try to deal with situations like this. Because I don't have much time, I can only share just one today and highlight that. I can talk about David when his son was so sick, and then he started talking to God. He fasted so many days, and after that, Mudimo abang kangwana wa hae. And then David are, why ke sontsore ke tswelle pele to cry? Mudimo nampile na ibile mudimo onkile a lebitso la morena lekele bokwe. Earlier on, he spoke about Job. It was very interesting that he lost all those things, his social life, his family life, everything. And then there was a time when he questioned God and said, what is happening here, Mudimo? Cursed be the day that I was born. Let it be cursed. Markete long, as you said, Ndayazi, ukuthi my Redeemer lives. And I'd like to encourage you, Ndadele me and the family, that you should also have that courage during your difficult moments, Ndadele Chabalala me, when you are wrestling with this. Ask God, but you know the answer it always be intandoyam, intandoyam. Lazarus in John 11. There we get a story. The family of Lazarus, he's sick. And Lazarus was a friend to Jesus. And they will go to Jesus and say, umngani wakho uyagula and is about to die. And then it happened that he died. Now Martha says, Jesus, if you were here, my brother would have not died. Because losing a son, it is not an easy thing. That is how I can talk to you. Dine lunge lokuthetha ndilapha nje, because I lost a son. It is not an easy thing to lose a son or a child. So that is why Martha goes to Jesus and say, if you were here, my brother would have not died. So Jesus says to her, look in verse 23 of chapter 11, your brother will rise again. And as I was sitting there, I was saying, this is what we can give ourselves comfort and hope on, that Jesus did say to Martha, your brother will rise again. Ndatele Mechawalala and the rest of the family, Tokulo will rise again, because Tokululo believed in Jesus. And for us who believe in Jesus, we believe that Christ died and Christ rose from the dead, and Christ will come again. So therefore, those who died believing in Jesus Christ will do what? They will die. But we know that they will be raised to new life when Jesus come again. Runaka sonarere. Highly funeral. We don't say rilogo patamutu. Rare rilogo murobatsa. It independe ke ngesixhosa ukuthi mamtshawe andive nkosikazi. Mamtshawe, thina asithi umntu uyafa. Sithi umntu uyalala. So sizayomlalisa lo mfana lo. Le ntwana le sizayoyilalisa ilindele ukuza kukaYesu. But njalo amasabatha ndithi tshawe. So as we leave this place today, Bazalwane, I plead with ourselves that as we leave this place and as his body is laid into the tomb, we are not burying him. Sithi nje kuye tokulo, khawukulale nje kancinci, silindele ukuza kukaKristu. That is why when we say rest in peace, that's exactly what you are saying. Makayo lala ngoxolo. So therefore, umntu mayelele ndathe Shawula, masiyekeni ukumhlupha ulele. Masiyekeni umhlupha, makayo lala alindele ukuza kwaKristu. And again, it's this one. And I always say, moba routine in my church, when you Lisa Matidiso, don't come across as if you know and understand the pain of the family. You don't know it. All you need to do is kastonarare oamutsidisa. There is a big river of mourning, of pain. All you can do is hold the hands of the family. Oba tsidise nokae. So Lord Nanta Chaba Shabalala Limme, Ritilohota Huli Tsidisa Nokae, Maripinione Yalona, you know it better than us. So may the Lord bless Tokulo, may he rest in peace. And as we say, in the everlasting glory of Jesus be raised. Thank you and God bless you. Amen. May I say some prayers, Bazalwane, as we pray for the family, as we pray for ourselves before we go.
Sukuti mayenzwe intando yakho halo tirundise ku mayenzwe
Let us commend our brother Tokulo to the mercy of God and our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Creator, by your mighty power you gave us life, and in your love you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We entrust to your merciful keeping in the faith of Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord, who died and rose again to save us and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit. In glory forever. Amen. We pray for the bereaved. God Almighty, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously with those who mourn, the Chabalala family, colleagues, friends, and everybody gathered here, that casting all their care on you, they may know the consolation of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And friends, we pray for ourselves. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left for us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, both the evil we have done and the good we have not done, and strengthen us to follow in the steps of your Son and in the way that leads to fullness of eternal life. Kajiso Christo Moreno Arona. Amen. May God, in his infinite love and mercy, bring the whole church, living and the departed, in the Lord Jesus to a joyful resurrection and the fulfillment of his eternal kingdom. Amen. Alleluia. 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 Dumela.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Dumelang, Alleluia. Ladies and gentlemen, re fihlile pheletsong ya tshebeletso ya lepato ka kerekeng ya mofu Tokollo Makesh Tshabalala. We are going to now proceed to West Park Cemetery where the burial rites and the interment is going to be performed. When we finish there, we all come back to this venue, Rhema Bible Church, for the refreshments that the family has kindly prepared for all of you, to which you are invited to take advantage of. As we leave, we are going to ask to observe some order in respect of the family. The pallbearers will come through now and will be led by the clergy. So it will be the clergy, followed by the pallbearers with the body, and then we'll have the immediate family, Baha Tshabalala Kalisika, le Baha Tshabalala Kakhomo, will follow. Thereafter, we'll have the MEC, Acting MEC for Arts, Sports and Culture, and MEC of Education in Gauteng, Mr. Panyaza Lesufi, together with Drs. Evan Khoza and Kaiser Mtaung, joining the profession. And after that, all of us will follow as we proceed to West Park Cemetery, Heroes Acres, where Tokollo Makesh Tshabalala is going to be laid to his final resting place. Shall you observe that? And let us do this with the utmost dignity that it deserves. Over to you, Mapaganee.